Hey YouTube, welcome to part number 16 of my NixOS configuration series. In today's video, I want to talk a little bit about deployment of NixOS configurations, especially when it comes to the Flake we have been using in the last couple of videos. The thing is really, we have been deploying our NixOS configuration to a remote machine, which was, in my case, just a VM I had hosted on my computer. But we were using a quite lengthy command to achieve that. And of course, just for now, we only have one system configuration in our Flake. But if you are using NixOS in a more professional context, chances are that you have multiple NixOS configurations in your Flake and you want to have an efficient way to deploy changes you made to the configuration to these machines. And that is a little bit tedious using the default commands. So in today's video, we will have a look into some deployment options, how you can make the deployment process a little bit easier, especially when it comes to managing multiple machines and configuration. So let's dive into it. So, of course, one thing you could do is you could basically just ask your friendly AI to help you create something like a Justfile or a Makefile to shorthand some of the commands you would use to update your Flake or to deploy your NixOS configurations you have on your Flake. So you could basically just give it a prompt and then give it the flake.nix as context, and AI will start generating a Justfile for you, like in this example here. And then you could just create a Justfile here and just copy in the stuff AI has suggested for you. And when we enter just in the terminal, you can see we get a small CLI menu, and we could just do just deploy, and then we just enter in the name of our NixOS configuration. And this will basically work as before. And of course, this is good enough for small configurations. And when you have, I don't know, like two or three system configurations in your Flake, this might be okay to make things a little bit easier. But there are also better solutions when it comes to deploying NixOS configurations, especially when you have a lot of machines you want to manage. And one thing I want to show you today is a project that's called Colmena. I hope I don't butcher the name too much. I don't actually know how it's spelled exactly, so sorry about that. And Colmena is a project that kind of solves the deployment stuff in a very elegant way. What this allows us to do is to define deployment options in our Nix Flake and also have separate options for each of our system configurations. And this will make deployment very easy because you could just deploy everything you have in your Flake, no matter if it's 2 or 20 NixOS machines. You could also work with tags. So you could have, I don't know, like 10 NixOS configurations which have a tag web or something, and then just deploy them all at once and with one command. And that makes it very fast and very useful managing larger projects and larger clusters of servers, really. So when we have a look here at the documentation for Colmena, you can see there is an example here. So to get started, the first thing we need to do is we need to put Colmena into the inputs of our Flake, and then we can just start a Colmena block here down in the outputs. And the first thing Colmena wants here is some meta information. So we will define here the default Nix packages to use and the default system architecture here. What I am also defining here is the special args argument to have all of our inputs and outputs from the Flake available. And when we scroll up, you can see this is very similar to what we have been using on our NixOS configuration. Then you can basically just start to build out the deployment nodes you want to use in Colmena. And this is done in a very simple and straightforward way. And when we have a look at the documentation and have a look at the deployment options, you can see that there are much more deployment options available. So for example, we could set an option to build on target. So that would basically copy the derivations to the target machine and then start the build process on the target machine. There are also a lot of other useful options you can have here for your deployments. But for now, we will just keep it simple so you can see how this works. And you have the same for the meta options. So for example, you have the allow apply all option, and this will basically define what happens when you don't enter a filter for the Colmena command. The default behavior is that it will deploy everything that is configured in your Nix Flake, and that can be, I don't know, like 5 or 10 or 20 system configurations. And for those of you who don't want it and who want to be a little bit more deliberate about what shall be built by default, you can just set this to false, and this will basically result in Colmena not doing anything unless you have set a filter or told it what to build exactly. What you can also do besides the default Nix packages, you can define individual settings for every node. So you could just go and define another version of Nix packages or have a different set of special arguments for one or more of your nodes, and that makes it very easy and very flexible to handle different configurations and different scenarios, really. So for example, we could just add the node Nix packages option here, and we could just refer to our node configuration from down here by name, and then we could just import Nix packages stable, and we have a small error here, and that's because we don't have Nix packages stable in our outputs. So let me quickly fix that. And then we could basically use Nix packages stable just for this deployment configuration here. So I will just remove that. So when we get down to the deploy node configuration here, you can see we have a couple of deployment options already defined. So I define the target host, I define the target user, which is my main user I have also used for deploying with the NixOS command. And here I just give it a tag VM. And when we have a look at the documentation and the examples here, and then we go to the main tutorial, you can see here in the examples that besides the deployment option, the deployment node is a regular NixOS system configuration. And that means in our case, we can just import the modules we are using up here in our defined NixOS configuration. So we import our main host we have defined in our hosts m3-creators. And we also import the disco module and the hnix module for the secrets. So that's basically mirroring what we are doing up here. And what's also mirrored here is the special args here. So as I said before, the special args are defined globally in the meta here in this example. And when I save this file and I hit Colmena apply, it will try to build our system configuration and activate it on the target system. And just for now, this will give an error. And as you can see, we're able to build the system configuration, but we were not allowed to switch to the new configuration because this requires sudo. So what we can do about that is I just go to my host configuration here and maybe just down here, I add an extra option where we say sudo wheel needs password equals false. And this will basically disable a password prompt for any of the sudo enabled users here. And this will basically also remove a layer of security. When you do something like that, please make sure that there is no password login into your remote machine that you are always using SSH keys. So another way to make this in a little bit more secure way is we could just add some extra config to our sudo configuration and just limit that to one user here, really. And this will just enable my main user to use sudo commands without passwords. And when it comes to deployment, it probably makes sense if you have a dedicated deployment user that's only used for deployments here to make it a little bit more secure. Just for now, we can just comment this out because this is just an alternative and save our system configuration. And of course, what we need to do is we need to send this over to our machine with the remove sudo command to apply it. And now it will rebuild our system configuration. And now this has rebuilt our system. And just let me clear out here. And now when I enter Colmena apply, this should work with our new system configuration now. And now you can see this has successfully built our system and deployed everything to our virtual machine. And what is also very nice about Colmena is I could just duplicate my deploy nodes here and have a version 1 and a version 2 and just save it here. And when I enter Colmena apply, you can see that it's trying to build 3 nodes. Of course, this is always the same system now, but this could be basically any amount of nodes here. And what you can also do is you can work with tags, for example. So when I have, I don't know, my last 2 nodes with a tag web here, we could just enter the command Colmena apply and then on, and then give it the tag web here. And now you can see it has selected 2 out of 3 hosts that are defined here. And of course, you can also mix and match different tags. So you can do very targeted deployments here based on tags and on names of your deployment nodes you have defined in here. And this makes it a very powerful and efficient deployment tool. And one more thing that's also quite nice about it is Colmena is also able to deploy locally. So you have a command that's Colmena apply local, and this can deploy a node configuration to the local system. So basically what you could do is when you have a Colmena configuration in your Nix Flake, you could basically just remove the system configuration block if you say you don't want to use the NixOS rebuild command and you want to use Colmena all the time for your deployments. And that makes it very easy and very powerful. And moreover, the Colmena deployment configurations here, as they are just basically regular NixOS configurations, they do not depend on the NixOS configurations you have already defined in your Flake. So you could go for just completely different sets here. And that makes it also very flexible to use, really. So that is a deployment solution I use for my systems at the moment and I use for my clients. And there are also other alternatives. So for example, there's a very nice project that's called deploy-rs, and that's very similar to Colmena, and that's also working very, very good. I have tried that a couple of times, and this is a very nice and reliable thing to deploy different machines. So if you want to make deployment a little bit more automatic and a little bit more easy, I can only encourage you to check out something like Colmena or deploy-rs. And of course, NixOS also already comes with a lot of possibilities when it comes to deployment. But if you don't want to type out lengthy commands or write your own scripts for deployment or whatever, these two solutions are quite good to try out. If you have any questions, just write me a DM or drop a comment. And yeah, that's it for today. So have a nice week. Bye-bye.